Hi, I am Maker Giovanni and welcome back on my channel. Today we will see how we can open our house gate with our phone. In fact, in my apartment building there is an electric gate that opens with a radio remote control. By modifying this remote control, we will be able to control the gate with the app on our phone, avoiding to carry the remote control with us all the time. The most important thing is that we will only modify the remote control, without touching anything on the gate, and therefore without risking damaging it. But now, let's get started! As I told you before, my gate opens with this remote control. Today's goal is to create a system that can press the remote control button when we give the command from the app. First, I disassemble the remote control. Inside, we have the circuit board and the battery. On the two terminals of the battery, there are 12 volts, but what happens if I connect the power supply instead of the battery? So, I connected my 12-volt bench power supply to the two contacts, and as you can see, the remote control LED lights up, so it might work. At this point, I removed the battery contacts and soldered two wires to the PCB, being careful to connect positive and negative as they were connected with the battery. Then I soldered the wire between the two contacts of the button, so that as soon as the remote control is powered on, it immediately sends a signal to open the gate. I went to the garage and when I connected the 12 volts to the remote control, the gate opened. So the basic idea works. Now I still need to connect the remote control to my smart home to control it with my phone. As we have seen, to open the gate we only need to give power to the remote control for a few seconds. So you could easily use a smart relay like a Shelly relay to control the remote control from the app. However, as always, I wanted to complicate my life by making everything from scratch. So I cut a piece of perf board, on which I put an ESP8266 board. This board is actually similar to an Arduino, but it has Wi-Fi connection, that will be very useful to connect it to Home Assistant. On the board I also put a relay and a linear voltage regulator, to bring the 12 volts that we will use to power the circuit to 5 volts for the ESP8266. To the input and output of the voltage regulator I connected two capacitors. I also soldered the transistor to control the relay, and the resistor to connect the base of the transistor to a pin on the ESP8266. To the coil of the relay I connected the flyback diode, to prevent the current left on the coil from damaging the other components when the relay is turned off. As a last thing, I put two terminals for the 12-volt power supply and for the output controlled by the relay, which will go to the remote control. I made all the connections under the board following the wiring diagram, and we are done. After using the circuit for a while, I noticed that the linear voltage regulator eats up a lot, and therefore is very inefficient. As soon as I get it shipped, I will replace it with a step-down converter, that will also reduce the power consumption. However, you guys can avoid all of this and use an already made product like a Shelly relay, even if it costs more. At this point I have connected the ESP8266 to Home Assistant using ESP Home. Since the software is a bit boring, if you are interested in the Home Assistant configuration, I will leave you the written guide with also the wiring diagrams in the description below. After programming everything on the Home Assistant page, I see this relay as it were a lock, with the button to unlock it. When I press the button, the relay turns on for 5 seconds and then turns off. Now to test the circuit I used an LED bulb, but at the output then I will connect the remote of the gate modified as we saw before. I put the circuit with connected the remote control on the balcony, press the button on the app, the remote turned on but the gate didn't open. Maybe I could have thought it earlier, but the gate is too far away from the balcony, so the remote control signal doesn't arrive to the gate. So I reflected on it for a while, and I thought that from the garage the remote control can open the gate. The problem is that the garage doesn't get Wi-Fi from home, so I couldn't move the whole circuit there. So I bought this small relay controlled by another remote control. The board with the relay has terminals for the 12-volt power supply and for the three contacts of the relay, of which we will use the normally open and the common. The relay is set on momentary, so it turns on when you press the button on the remote control, and it turns off when you let the button. My idea is to put the relay remote control in the home connected to the relay controlled via Wi-Fi. Instead, the relay controlled by the remote will be in the garage, and the gate remote control will be connected to the relay. That way, as soon as I press the button on the app, the first remote sends a signal to the relay, which then activates the gate remote. However, to know if this works, we can only try. Also, the relay remote runs on a 12-volt battery, so I made the same modifications as the other remote so that when the remote is powered, it starts sending the signal to the relay. Finally, something worked, and as soon as I clicked on the app, the gate opened. So the circuit works. Now we just need to create boxes in which to mount the various parts. To mount the board connected to my smart home and the remote of the relay that will stay in the garage, I 3D printed these two boxes with their lids. The boxes have holes to mount cable glands. To power the circuit in the garage and the one in the home, I recovered these two 12-volt power supplies. The remote control will be placed away from the ESP8266 to avoid interference with Wi-Fi. On the lid of the first box, I put an LED to indicate the connection status, and I connected it to the board. I put the ESP8266 and the remote control on the balcony. Instead, the relay and the gate remote control will be put on the garage door to get a stronger radio signal. To mount them, I designed and printed this little box. I redid the connections between the relay and the remote control so that they will be more compact, and I also soldered the connector for the power supply. I wanted to put a button to open the gate directly from the garage, so on the connector I also carried the power for the remote control of the gate. The cable coming from the connector goes into another box, along with the power supply cable. On the lid I put a button to open the gate and an LED to indicate whether the relay received the signal. At this point I mounted the small box with the relay and the remote control on the garage door, running the cable through the grills. I secured the little box with a bolt and the nut placed behind the door. Then I mounted the button above the garage electrical outlet with zip ties and closed the lid of the box. I immediately went to see if the circuit worked, so I opened the Home Assistant app and pressed the button to open the gate. When I saw that everything worked, I was quite surprised, because I would have expected to have other problems. As you saw, for the cable that goes from the door to the button, I chose a spiral cable, because it always stays quite taut, and so it doesn't risk getting into the door mechanism. In the end, the remote control of the relay is quite powerful, so instead of putting it on the balcony, I put it inside home on top of the kitchen cabinets, where the whole thing is protected from the rain and where there is also a lot of dust keeping it company. And so this video ends here, and if you want to see more electronics videos like this one, subscribe to my channel. Bye, and we will see you in the next video with another project.